Hi Tua, good morning to everyone. I'm very happy to welcome this session. Today we discuss about the paper Nuclear and Particle Physics. Within this paper, we discuss some basic concepts on the nucleus. At first, nuclear mass. Nuclear mass is the fundamental property of the nucleus. That means all atomic nuclei are made up of elementary particles called protons and neutrons. A proton has a positive charge of the same magnitude as that of an electron, you know that. So the neutron is an electrically neutral. The proton and the neutron are considered to be a two different charge states of the same particle, which is called as a nucleon. So it is called as a nucleon. So here you see the atomic structure. In this atomic structure, the center part is look like a denser part. So in the denser part consists of protons and the neutrons. It's simply called as a nucleon. So a nucleus is consists of Z protons and neutrons and N neutrons. The mass of the nucleus is called as M of Z, N. Then, if a nucleus is assumed to be a simple collection of Z protons and N neutrons, the masses of the nucleus would be just the sum of the masses of this constituent nucleus. That it can be written as ZMP plus NMN, where MP is the mass of the proton and MN is the mass of the neutron. So, inside the nucleus, inside the nucleus, the nucleons are tightly bound to each other, which is possible due to the nuclear forces, because of the nuclear forces are the very strong and attractive forces. So, however, a nucleus is not a simple collection of protons and neutrons, but they are strongly combined with each other through a strong and attractive force that is called the nuclear force. Next one is the nuclear stability. The nuclear stability means that the nucleus of an element is stable and thus it does not decay spontaneously, emitting any kind of radioactivity, is called as the nuclear stability. Okay, the ratio, the nuclear stability is calculated with the number of protons and the number of neutrons ratio. That means N is the ratio curve. The ratio of the neutron to proton is a successful way in predicting the nuclear stability. You see this figure, this ratio is close to 1 for atoms of elements with low atomic numbers of less than about 20 protons. The neutron-proton ratio is steadily increases as the atomic number increases past the element 20, that means the calcium, to about the element 84. 84 element name is polonium. So every element beyond an atomic number of 84 is unstable. So what we conclude from this NZ ratio, for proton numbers up to 20, N is equal to Z is a straight line. The N is equal to Z means a symmetric effect. And for nuclei with Z is greater than 20, the stable nuclei have more neutrons than protons. So the line curves move upwards. The unstable nuclei above the stability curve are called a neutron-rich region. It is indicated as a green dot. And unstable nuclei is called the neutron-poor region. It is indicated as a red dot. Okay. Next one is the Mohs defect. You see, this is a simple explanation of the Mohs defect. You see, I take the helium nucleus. The helium nucleus mass is 4.0026 units. And then in a free state, the helium in a free state, the two proton and the two neutron masses are the 4.0330 U. What we conclude from this, in a free state, the masses are so high when compared to the compared into the nucleus. So what is happening here? Here the masses are converted into the energy that's called as binding energy. So this reduced mass is called as the Mohs defect. This Mohs defect is converted as a binding energy. So it can be written as, so del M is equal to, that is Mohs defect is equal to ZMP plus NMN minus M of Z, N. So what we conclude from this, Mohs defect is a measure of binding energy of an atom. More of the Mohs defect, more tightly the nucleon will be bound in the nucleus. Then the next parameter is the packing fraction. Okay. In this word, packing fraction was introduced by the scientist Astron in 1926. Okay. The packing fraction is defined as F is equal to atomic mass minus mass number divided by mass number. We know that atomic mass minus mass number is a Mohs defect, that is mentioned as del M. So your packing fraction F is equal to del M divided by A. Okay. What we conclude from the packing fraction graph, so actually the packing fraction graph is drawn in between the atomic mass number versus the packing fractions. I show the packing fraction curve, so for a different element. From this curve, we conclude that the packing fraction's value may be positive sign or negative sign. The positive packing fraction describes a tendency towards instability. A negative packing fraction means isotopic masses is less than the actual mass number. Okay, the difference is due to the transformation of mass into the energy in the formation of nucleus. A graph is in the graph within this graph, the elements which have less atomic masses like hydrogen, helium, carbon do not fall in the curve. Therefore, these are stable atoms. Oxygen is highly stable. Okay, the packing fraction beyond the masses, that is 200, because of the positive and the increases with the increasing the mass number. So the instability beyond the 200, the instability is continuously increases. Okay, so the packing fraction is an important parameter to decide whether the nucleus is stable or unstable. Okay, the next one is the binding energy. This is the important the next important thing is the binding energy. The binding energy means the minimum amount of energy are required to bind the nucleons inside the nucleus is called as the binding energy. According to the Einstein mass energy relation, it can be written as E is equal to mc square. On the basis of mass defect, this equation can be rewritten as del E is equal to del m into c square. Here, del m is the mass defect. The corresponding energy del E is the binding energy. By experimentally, it can be rewritten as ZMP plus LMN, that is the abbreviation of mass minus reduced mass minus del M. This term is called as the reduced mass into C square. So it produces some value. So the magnitude of the binding energy of the nucleus determines its instability. You suppose when nucleus has the highest binding energy value, it implies the nucleus has the high stability. Suppose the binding energy is small, it means the nucleus is starts to disintegrate itself. Okay, so now I show one simple nucleus that is called a deuteron. The deuteron is the combination of one proton and one neutron. It's a simple nucleus formation. Okay. Now we calculate the binding energy of the deuteron nucleus. So in this way, the masses of the one proton is 1.5, we know that 1.7007276 units. Similarly, the masses of the neutrons is 1.008665. Okay, so therefore, the masses of the proton and neutron in free state is 2.015941, just to add these two values. Okay, then already we found that the masses of the deuteron nucleus is 2.013553. Now, the mass defect is you can subtract these two values and we get 0.002388 U. So the binding energy, now binding energy in a milli electron volt format, so you can multiply with the 931 MeV. That means one unit is 1 U is equal to 931 MeV. Therefore, binding energy is equal to 0.002388 into 931 MeV. It gives 2.23 MeV. So from this calculation we can conclude that the deuteron has the binding energy of 2.23 MeV. If you apply the 2.23 MeV photonic energy on the deuteron, it releases one proton and one neutron. Next one is the binding energy per nucleon curve. It is very important parameter for the nuclear physics. So what is the binding energy per nucleon? It is defined as total binding energy of the nucleus divided by the nucleon it contains. If this quantity is relatively large, the nucleus is relatively stable. So okay, from this graph, the binding energy per nucleon value is greatest for the nuclei with the mass number near 56. You see the graph is near the 56. Less than the 56, the fusion process is occurs. The greater than 56, the fission process is started. That means the exothermic process. So this is most important phenomena in energy production process. Okay. Next, the Weisskill semi-empirical mass formula. The Weisskill semi-empirical mass formula is an important formula for the nuclear structures. The Weisskill in 1935 derived this formula for the liquid drop model of the nucleus. He says the binding energy is not a single energy, it is a combination of five different energy modes. That means volume energy, surface energy, Coulomb energy, asymmetric energy and pairing energy. So he wrote a formula like binding energy is equal to A AR minus B A power 2 by 3 and C Z into Z minus 1 divided by A power 1 by 3 minus D into N minus Z whole square divided by A and plus or minus del whole divided by A power 3 by 4. Here A, B, C, D are the del are the constants. Okay. Now, the first term is the volume energy term. Now, we discuss the volume energy term. Now, the volume energy means if the number of nucleons is increases inside the nucleus, the binding energy is also increases. So it means what? Therefore, we get a term proportional to the volume, that is proportional to A. Okay. This term reflects yes the short range nature of the strong forces. Okay. If a nucleon interacted with all other nucleons, we would expect an energy term proportional to A into A. A of A minus N and then interaction is also lesser. So the surface energy term is negative energy term in, with respect to the binding energy. So the surface energy terms can be rewritten as ES is equal to minus BA power 2 by 3. Next one is the Coulomb energy term. The Coulomb energy term indicates that from maximum, although the binding energy is mainly due to the strong nuclear force. Okay, the binding energy is reduced owing to the Coulomb repulsions between the protons. So the interaction if the proton interaction increases, the electrostatic repulsions also increases. Due to this electrostatic repulsion, the binding energy is decreases. So what we conclude from this, if the Coulomb energy is increases, then binding energy of the nucleus also decreases. So this is also called as the negative energy term. The next one is the asymmetric energy term. Asymmetry. What is meant by symmetry? If n is equal to z, that is the number of neutrons equal to number of protons, it's called the symmetry effect. Suppose if disturbances occur, that means n is equal to z, n minus z, or n is not equal to z, it gives an instability. So asymmetric effect produces the decreasing the binding energy. So this is also the negative energy. Okay. The last one is the pairing energy term. It fully depends upon the number of nucleons nucleons pair. Okay. If the nucleus has the even nuclei pair, that nucleus is in more stable. The pairing energy term del is a positive. Suppose if it is even odd nuclei pair, they have the less stable, so del is the negative. Okay, and then odd or nuclei have the most unstable. So now we can draw a graph for this energy term. So mass number A in x-axis and the binding energy per nucleon in y-axis, we get the four energy terms like this. So then the application of this formula is like a formula. Using this formula, we can find the Coulomb radius of the nucleus to find the radius of the mirror nuclei. Okay, and then this formula used to explain the fission process also. So we can calculate the total liberated in alpha decay energy process. So in alpha decay, using this formula, we can calculate the energy of the alpha decay process, and we can we can study the beta decay process also. Okay, so today classes is over. We will see the next class. Okay, bye. Thank you so much.